Good morning.
Try again.
He is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Welcome to Vale Church. I'm Terry Lowry. I'm your lay reader this morning. And we welcome all the visitors that are here today, quite a few of them. We have welcome bags for you that are available.
Actually, we don't. We're out.
Oh, sorry. Well, we don't. Sorry. Sorry about that. But welcome. Come back. And we're just glad you're here with us enjoying this beautiful Easter morning. Are there any announcements? I have a few I wanted to highlight. Next Sunday is our morning of service, and there are several opportunities for you to serve. We'll have a short service here, and then we're going out into the community. And in your bulletin, you'll see several options. You can sign up or just come.
It helps if you sign up, and there's a spot for just we know you're coming. We have a few things that we know we need people for. If we don't have enough, we have to cancel it. And last year we canceled, and we had enough people anyway. So it really does help us if you sign up to prepare, to respect the people who are setting up, giving their time for us to come and do ministry with them. So thank you.
Also, there is no Sunday school this morning, so that the children will stay after the children's sermon. If there are no other announcements, let's turn our hearts. Oops, sorry. Melissa?
Good morning. Happy Easter. I think I spoke with all of the parents and children, but if I didn't, I'd like to personally invite all of the children to stay after service for Easter egg hunt. So around 11 o'clock, we'll go into the fellowship hall and we'll have separate sections for preschool age children and older children up to age 13. So please feel free.
What's the age cutoff on that?
13.
I can't come, Mike. All right. If there are no other announcements, let's turn our hearts to worshiping God.
Thank you.
Please rise as you are able and join in the call to worship. Early on the first day of the week, the disciples of Jesus went to the tomb where he had been buried, only to find that the stone had been rolled away and the tomb was empty. Friends, we gather here as Christ's disciples on the first day of the week to celebrate the good news of the gospel. Jesus Christ has risen from the dead. Rejoice and be glad.
This is the day that the Lord has made.
Rejoice and be glad.
Heaven and earth will never be the same.
Rejoice and be glad.
Christ is risen. Hallelujah.
Our first hymn is number 302, verses 1 through 4. Join in the prayer of confession. Since sin and death came through a human being, the resurrection of the dead has also come through a human being. For as all die in Adam, all will be made alive in Christ. Trusting in that promise of God, let us confess our sin. Gracious God, we have heard the good news, how on the third day Christ rose again.
Still we look for the living among the dead.
You rolled away the stone from the tomb.
Still, we look for the living among the dead.
You sent messengers to proclaim the gospel.
Still, we look for the living among the dead.
You were faithful to your promise. You have done wonderful things.
Still, we look for the living among the dead.
Forgive us, Lord, we pray. Teach us to trust your promise and to believe the good news of salvation.
Christ is alive. Jesus is risen from the dead. Amen.
When Christ comes to reign, he will put an end to every ruler, every power, every authority. He will put every enemy under his feet, and the last enemy to be destroyed is death. As we await that great and glorious day, we rejoice in the good news of the gospel. In Jesus Christ, we are forgiven. Thanks be to God.
In Jesus Christ, we are forgiven. Thanks be to God.
You may be
Amen.
You may be seated.
Our scripture this morning is from the Gospel of John, chapter 20, verses 1 through 18. Hear now the word of the Lord. Early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one whom Jesus loved, and said to them, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they have laid him." Then Peter and the other disciples set out and went toward the tomb. The two were running together, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He bent down to look in and saw the linen wrappings lying there, but he did not go in. Then Simon Peter came, following him, and went into the tomb. He saw the linen wrappings lying there and the cloth that had been on Jesus' head, not lying with the linen wrappings, but rolled up in a place by itself. Then the other disciple who reached the tomb first also went in, and he saw and believed. For as yet they did not understand the scripture that he must rise from the dead. Then the disciples returned to their home. But Mary stood weeping outside the tomb. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb, and she saw two angels in white, sitting where the body of Jesus had been lying, one at the head and the other at the feet. They said to her, "Mary, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "They have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him." When she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not know that it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you looking for?" Supposing him to be the gardener, she said to him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him in Hebrew, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Do not hold on to me, because I have not yet ascended to the Father. But go to my brothers and say to them, 'I am ascending to my Father and to your Father, to my God and your God.'" Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord." And she told them that he had said these things to her. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Let us spend a moment in reflection on God's word. Now, O Lord, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight, my rock and my redeemer. Amen. We're going to do this a little different. We're going to have the children's choir come up with some special music first.
Thank you. pictures in here are just beautiful. Please hurry, children. I'll show you the pictures when I'm done. It's hard. Please hurry, children. Hop, 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 instructed one on the floor. The sparrow says he's got big news. We're meeting at the wall. Soon, all the nearby animals were heading down to the road. The hare, the deer, the billy goat, and even Mr. Turtle. And they all got down to the wall and away from the sparrow. The sparrow came. The animals became quite still. They looked up at the bird. The chipmunk called, "Hey, Sparrow, sir, please tell us, what's the word?" "I've called you here," the sparrow said, "to tell you what I saw. A miracle has come to pass. In fact, I am still in awe." What is awe? What is in awe? You know?
Amazement.
Amazement would be another word, wouldn't it? Miracle, the donkey asked. "We really want to know." "I've seen God's son," the sparrow said. "I heard he died," said Doe. "No, he's alive," the sparrow said. "You see that tomb right there? He was inside, and then he walked out." "How can this be?" asked the hare. "I'm not sure how this came about," the sparrow softly spoke, "but he was dead, and now he's alive. It's true. This is no joke. But I saw what they did to him," declared the chickadee. "They beat him, and they spat on him, and hung him on a tree. Look at the hanging on. A cross, right? And the cross is made out of wood from a tree. They needed a word to grind." "And later on that day, he died," the chickadee went on. "And all at once, the sky grew dark. The sun was simply gone." "I do not know what happened next," confessed the chickadee. "But I do know," Sparrow said, "because I was here, you see." "They brought him here," the sparrow shared, "to rest forevermore. But he was only dead 3 days. Then he walked out the door. I was asleep up in the tree before the break of day. And when I opened up my eyes, the stone was rolled away." "So that's how he got out," said Toad. "Tell us, where did he go?" "I'm not real sure," the sparrow said. "Is there more news?" asked Joe. "Oh, yes," Sparrow gave a tweet. "There's so much more to share. The women came to see the Christ. Of course, he wasn't there. When they discovered he was gone, they all were very sad. But then an angel of the Lord had news to make them glad." "This angel," she said, "he isn't here. He's risen from the dead. Now go tell everybody else this thing that I have said." "So what does all this mean?" asked Hare. "Please tell us," chimed in Goat. The sparrow thought, and then he said, "It's like the prophet wrote. Jesus the Christ was sent to earth to die upon a tree. But on the third day he arose, and now mankind is free." Free from what? What are we free from?
Sin.
Come on.
Sin.
Free from sin? Free from death, because we'll live forever in heaven, right?
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's the news the sparrow shared. This is a special day. "It really is," the donkey said. "It makes me want to pray." "This news is not too great, This news is too great not to share," called out the little squirrel. "I must go tell." other creatures, great and small, began to spread the word. They shared the sparrow's awesome news to everyone who had heard. Right? And we want to spread the good news of Jesus too, that he died on the cross, that he rose. And God loved us so much that he gave us his son to die on the cross so that we could live forever with him one day. And we could be free of our sin. God died, Jesus died on the cross for all of our sins so that our sins would be forgiven. Isn't that a wonderful God that would give, that would love us that much that he would give his son to die on the cross? Heavenly Father, we come today with hearts full of love and thanksgiving as we remember that first Easter morning. We are in awe of the depth of the love you have for us, a love so great that you sent your only Son to die on the cross to save us. Because of Jesus' death, our sins are forgiven. We know that one day we will live eternally in heaven with you. Thanks be to you, our God and our Redeemer.
It's good to see everybody again as we gather for this glorious Easter day. This is my 19th year of ministry. I've been doing this 19 times, and here we are. What's new? What's different? It's the same story. Well, there are four Gospels. We have four different accounts of it. And if you remember last week, I mentioned that I had gone to see the Star Wars movie when I was 14, 8 times in the theater. So I can keep doing this. But if that's all it is, then it becomes boring and mundane and really, why do we bother? But the secret is, it's not the end of the story. It was the end of Jesus' earthly ministry, but it was the beginning of a new story. A new story in the life of Mary Magdalene and the 12 disciples. But more importantly, a new life in you and in me. This new story that we are always telling. It's not always easy. Think about Mary. All her hopes, her dreams, ideas of what Jesus was going to do and be were gone. He was her salvation. He had guided her. He had transformed her life. And he was gone. I don't know what she expected, but whatever it was, poof. And yet, here she is. I wonder, I think a lot of times in grief, we continue through our motions. And that's not a bad thing. It keeps us going sometimes. And Mary didn't know what to do, but she could anoint his body. They had not been able to do that earlier. And so she came as soon as she could, while it was still dark, it says. She came. But she still had trouble understanding the resurrection. You know, we often think less of the disciples when they don't get it. But we have the opportunity to see it from this side of the resurrection. And that gives us so much more, so much better perspective. A new hope for a new story. Jesus spoke her name, and she discovered that new story. That new life in Christ is what gives us hope for today. Often we are in the dark. We don't know what's going to happen next. But we put our faith, our trust, our hope in Jesus. And that gets us through. And so when my niece is killed by a tornado in a church on Palm Sunday, we still have hope. When a couple in the family, a church I'm serving there, when their daughter is abducted and brutally murdered, we still have hope. And at the same time that happened, a young man died very suddenly, leaving two small children. And you wonder, where is God in all this? And you discover a new story of life and of hope. We discover the joy when we gather each Sunday. When we have weddings, we celebrate births, we celebrate baptisms. When we take Holy Communion in celebration of Christ's presence in our lives. That's the story. Story of new hope and new life. Not the same old, same old. Yeah, the beginning's the same. But today the story is different. And it's different in me, it's different in you, it's different in us as a church. It's a story to live and to proclaim each new day with each person. If you were at our sunrise service, you could hear our youth talk. You could see them. The presence of Christ in their life and what that's done for them. What's your story? How is the risen Christ transforming you? And changing your story. That's why we're here today. To celebrate. Not that past historical event. But what that means for us. Today. Here and now. Our story. A new beginning. For our eternity. And for this we give God. Our thanks. And our praise. For Jesus is risen. He's risen. Indeed. Will you pray with me? Lord, your will. Nothing more, nothing less, nothing else. Amen. Will you stand as you are able for our hymn, number 310, He Lives. Serve a risen Savior, He's in the world today. I know that He is living, no matter men's they say. I heed His hand of mercy, I hear His voice of cheer. Just the time I need Him, He's always near. He lives, He lives, Christ Jesus lives today. He walks with me and talks with me along life's narrow way. He lives, salvation to impart. You ask me how I know He lives. He lives within my heart. In all the world around me, His loving care. Stormy blast, the day of His appearing will come at last. He lives, He lives, Christ Jesus lives today. He walks with me and talks with me along life's narrow way. He lives, He lives, salvation to impart. You ask me how I know He lives. Yeah. turn in your hymnal to page 880 for the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, eternally begotten God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried.
On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures.
He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshiped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in the holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. You may be seated. As we gather this morning from our earlier service, a couple of prayer concerns. One were for the Christians in Sri Lanka who were suffered a terrorist attack there. Also, Diane asked for prayers for the family of Ed Halleck as he has passed. Others this morning, Joyce. Certainly keep the barn hearts. Yes. Lots of prayers. Others this morning.
Prayers for my grandmother as she's in the last couple of days of hospice care.
Kevin's grandmother in hospice care. Jennifer.
David's grandmother, Betty Spuel, is the last stages of lung cancer.
Oh. All right. David's grandmother, Betty. Any others? Eric.
I just have joy to see the great turnout here at Easter. A lot of faces we haven't seen in a while, some new faces, and nice to see them.
Good to see everybody. Where are the hats? Where are all the hats? There's two. Come on. Thank you. Thank you. Are there any others? Oh. Wonderful. All right. Let us turn to the Lord in our prayers.
Joy we share as we tarry there, none other has ever
Gracious and loving God, we give you thanks for the Easter story, for new life, for light out of darkness, for your presence, and for our story that is new every day, rooted in you. And as we gather together this morning, Lord, we lift up these joys and concerns to you. We pray for your people throughout the world. We lift up those who are persecuted for their faith. We pray for those who work to share their faith and your love with others. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
We pray for the nations of the earth, for all the peoples. We lift up those in authority and pray that they would seek your kingdom and not their own. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
We pray for the poor, the sick, the hungry, the oppressed, the prisoners, the unemployed, the underemployed, for all those in need. Bring comfort to those who sorrow and strength to those who suffer. Give us the wisdom and the courage to serve them as you have taught us. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
We pray for the mission of the church, for your mission and ministry here at Vale, and we pray for the coming of your kingdom to all. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
Let us give thanks for all of God's goodness. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
You are worthy, O God, to receive honor and blessing and praise, for you reign in the glory of the power that is your love, now and forever. Amen. And now with the confidence as God's children, we pray the prayer that Jesus taught his disciples, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. And now if the ushers would come forward to receive God's tithes and our offerings. seated. If you'll turn in your hymnals to page 15 for our order of Holy Communion. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give our thanks and praise. In every time and in every age, O God, it is good and faithful that we give you thanks. For your mercy is sure, and your steadfast love endures forever. In your compassion, you gave us Christ Jesus, who frees us from darkness and lights our path to endless renewal and life eternal. And so, with all of creation, with all the needy and hungry ones, with all those who have enough and plenty, with creatures great and small, with sun and moon and stars, and with the saints of every age, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed are you, O God, creator of all things, for by your power and love you continue to deliver your people from bondage, to thwart the designs of evil, show the way through the wilderness, and to turn hardship into righteousness, and reveal your hand upholding the just. Blessed are you, O Christ, servant of the universe. You came among us to feed and heal and teach, to confound the haughty, to confuse the trickster, to challenge the wrong-hearted, and in all these things to give hope to those who long for peace. We remember that on the night in which Jesus was betrayed, he gathered his friends at the table. Our Lord took the bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And again, after the supper, he took the cup and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant of my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering our Lord's self-giving love, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Blessed are you, O Spirit, giver of life. For you give us words when we have none. You fill us with vision when we have the most need. You give us voice to proclaim our faith in every hour. Be our guide and teacher today and always. Come now, O Prince of Peace, Spirit of Love, Breath of Life. Bring to all this hurting world the joy that Mary knew, and teach us to proclaim with her, "I have seen the Lord." In the unity of the Holy Trinity, in gratitude for this great day of resurrection, we praise you, God, of all that is, now and forever. Amen. The body of Christ, broken for you. The blood of Christ, shed for you. Body of Christ, God's gift for you. The blood of Christ, new life for you.
Body of Christ, shed for you.
Thanks be to God. Christ our Lord invited to his feast his 12 disciples, including Peter, who was to deny him, and Judas, who was to betray him. None of us are worthy, but Christ comes and invites us to be made worthy in him.
We will move that out of the way. We will invite you to come up. We'll start from the front, work our way back. If you would like communion in your pews, we will be happy to bring it to you. The basket here is to help those in our community in need. But let us come to this feast. The body of Christ broken for you. And I have communion free of elements available if that's your wish. Just let me know.
join me in our communion prayer. Almighty God, you provide the true bread from heaven, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Grant that we who have received the sacrament of his body and blood may abide in him and he in us, that we may be filled with the power of his endless life, now and forever. Amen. Will you stand for our closing hymn, number 322, Up from the Grave He Arose.
Jesus, my Lord, I
Our benediction, I will say he is risen. I want you to reply, he is risen indeed. I will start softly. We will do this three times, getting louder each time. Let's really proclaim it. He is risen.
He is risen indeed.
He is risen.
He is risen indeed.
He is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Amen.